I am Dr. R. Krishnaveni, Associate Professor in PG and Research Department of Commerce, ADM College for Women Autonomous. I am going to teach the principles of accountancy for the first year BCom students. The origin and evolution of accounting, bookkeeping, definition of accounting, steps of accounting, accounting cycle, types of accounting, and the rules of accounting. Next, the evolution of accountancy. The evolution of accountancy can be divided into the following four development stage. One is the primitive age, from the year 1494, pre-analytical period 1494 to 1800, analytical period 1800 to 1950, then the last period, current period, modern period, post to 1950. The primitive age, 1494. So in this age, people used different type of images, symbols, cave engraving. This stage is called as a stone age. Or by making a mark on the wall for bookkeeping. Even in our village, people used to mark on the wall, a tally mark for the purchase of milk. So in this era, an instrument called abacus was used in China for accounting. The abacus used. Pre-analytical period, 1494 to 1800. In this period, the trade and commerce expanded rapidly. In this age only, the great Italian mathematician Luca Pacioli is known as the father of accounting and bookkeeping. In this period only, the debit and credit of accounts, that is called double entry system, starts. The double entry system of accounting starts. Then third, analytical period, 1800 to 1950. In this era, the accounting research started and new theories were invented, and the propagation of modern accounting began on this era only. In the current year, the current modern period, post to 1950 onwards. In this time, there was a great change in the science of accounting. Accounting standards have issued, the Indian accounting standards or the international accounting standards, and even the various branches of accounting like cost accounting, management accounting, tax accounting have emerged. Nowadays, accounts are kept in the computer rather manually. Accounts are kept in computers. Even the tally, the power of simplicity, is also used. The origin of Indian bookkeeping of accounts. The early accounting in India. Early references to accounting concept are found in the Veda period. Vigraha is found in the other Veda, and the Nirkada denoting SAL, Chukla in the Rig Veda, clearly means a price. In the Dharma Sutras, it denotes a tax. Then, origin of Indian bookkeeping of accounts. In India, also there is an adequate evidence of systematic accounting method used in the ancient period. Though it is claimed that double entry bookkeeping is originated and developed in Italy, there is a sufficient ground to believe that the double entry system, though not specifically called as such, originated and developed in ancient India. The art of bookkeeping, like the science of numbers, just passed to Italy and further developed there. Even the Kaudilya, an author, wrote Arthashastra in India 23rd centuries ago. Chandragupta, a minister, Kaudilya wrote a book named The Famous Arthashastra. Not only relates to politics and economics, but also explains the art of account keeping. Kaudilya has devoted a separate chapter on business of keeping of accounts in office accountant, written in 4th century BC in Sanskrit verses. The book gives details about bookkeeping, accountant office, method of supervising and checking of accounts, and also about the distinction between capital and revenue, profit and expenses. Everything is informed in the book named Arthashastra. Then bookkeeping, you have to come to the definition or meaning of bookkeeping. A systematic record of daily events of business leading to presentation of complete financial picture is known as accounting, or in the elementary stage of bookkeeping. So the definition of bookkeeping is an art of recording day-to-day business transactions in a set of book in a most systematic manner. That is called as bookkeeping. Definition of accountancy. The famous American Institute of Certified Public Accountant Committee on Terminology proposed in 1941 that accounting may be defined as art of recording, classifying and summarizing in a significant manner and in terms of money transactions and events which are in part at least of financial character and interpreting the results thereof. So it is an art of recording, classifying and summarizing in a significant manner and in terms of money transactions and events which are in part at least of financial character and interpreting the results thereof. Then when you come to the steps of accounting, the above definitions, it is an art of recording, classifying and summarizing. Recording, you have to record the entries in journal book. It is a very lengthy process. You cannot verify or clarify immediately. So we are taking into the ledger account. You are classifying all the journals and taken to ledger account. Each and individual accounts are maintained in ledger. Then with the ledger balances, you are summarizing and taking to the trial balance. All the summarized ledger balances are taken to a trial balance. The trial balance have to keep tally. Then only you have done it in a correct sense. That is, journal and ledgers are corrected. With the help of trial balance, you have to prepare the financial statement. The financial statement contains the trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet. This can be explained through accounting cycle also. The picture is accounting cycle, the sources of document. What are the sources of document means? The vouchers, bills and other documents are carrying and taking into account, and you are entering with the help of those documents, you are entering into the journal books. Journal entries are recorded. With the help of journal only, you are preparing the ledger account. Ledgers are carried on to trial balance. All the ledger balances are carried on to trial balances. The trial balance have to tally. Then with the help of the trial balance, you are preparing the financial statement. The financial statement contains trading account, profit and loss account and balance sheet. This is called as an accounting cycle. Then when you come to the types of accounts, there are two types of account. One is called as a personal account and another one is impersonal account. Personal account, the natural personal account. Natural person means you and I. As a natural person, artificial personal account is a man-made person, like a sole trading business, partnership business, company type of business, corporate sector business comes under the artificial personal account. Then representative personal account, the drawing account, or you may receive some advances may be received, advance received from salary or prepaid. Every prepaid wages, this may be called as a representative personal account. Then when you come to the impersonal account, impersonal account is again divided into two. One is the real account and another one is the nominal account. Real accounts informs about the cash dealings, and nominal accounts informs about the losses or gain. That is called as a nominal account. Then this may be framed into a rule called the golden rule. We are saying without this rule, we cannot able to enter into the journal. So you have to be, that's why whether it is a small business or it is a big business, you have to follow the same rule. That is why it is called as a golden rule, the personal account rule, debit the receiver. Debit the receiver, those who are received from the business, that is called as a debit the receiver, credit the giver. Those who are giving to the business is a credit the giver. This is the personal account rule. When you come to the real account rule, debit what comes in, whatever comes into the business. Real account is about dealing of cash. So debit what comes into the business and whether the credit what goes out, what cash is going out of the business, it is called as a real account rule. Debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Then when you come to the nominal account, debit all expenses and losses. Whatever the business incurs any loss or incurs any expenses, all expenses you have to be debited. Then when you gain, when you get any gain, that is the business get any gain or income, that should be credited. So debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gain. This is the most important rule. That's why we are calling as a golden rule. Personal account rule is debit the receiver, credit the giver. Real account rule, debit what comes in, credit what goes out. Nominal account rule, debit all expenses and losses, credit all incomes and gain. So with this, thank you very much.